गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, यस्टरडे आई डिस्कस होल अबाउट द अमीनो एसिड्स, देयर फंक्शंस, इसेंशियल नॉन इसेंशियल, देयर टाइप्स एंड ऑल्सो आई डिस्कस लिटिल मोर अबाउट द पेप्टाइड बॉन्ड्स एंड आई टोल्ड यू दैट इफ द नंबर ऑफ amino acids more than or equal to 1000, they are termed as the polypeptides. Okay, polypeptides, here you see polypeptides. Okay, and above the 1000, polypeptides are known as proteins. Okay, proteins, they are the linear polymer of alpha, not A, alpha amino acid. They are the polymer of alpha amino acids. Okay. And there are three structures of protein: primary, secondary, tertiary. Primary structure of the protein, it represent the sequence of amino acid only. It show the sequence of amino acid. But secondary, as the number of amino acid in the chain increases, the strain develop in the linear chain. And this strain results to different type of structure. And due to strain, to different type of bonds also develop, such as hydrogen bond, such as sulfide bond. On the basis of this alpha helix structure, this one is the alpha helix structure and the beta pleated structure. Helical structure primary structure is like this, okay, only linear, but secondary structure is like helix, this like the DNA helix. Why it occur? Due to strain. Okay, and beta pleated structure is like the sheet. Like this, and there is sulfur. And these two are bond together by the sulfide bond. In some there is hydrogen bond. Okay, this way pleated structure is formed due to the hydrogen or by the sulfur. This way, as the atomic mass or number of amino acid increases, structure changes. First helical structure due to the hydrogen bonding. Helical structure is due to the hydrogen bonding. Pleated structure is due to sulfide bonding. Number of R group may also cause the strain for formation of such type of structure. And tertiary structure is a result of the folding. When the further number of amino acid increases, folding takes place and superposition takes place. Like this one is the chain, above this another chain develop, folding takes place, more and more folding takes place. This way tertiary structure is formed, and this one is the globular shape, okay, just like the albumin, which is the globular protein, okay. And this when the arrangement is also precise, means further arrangement, next one more chain is inserted in this one, we get the quaternary structure. Thus the student, once again I will explain, primary structure is linear one, only a plain chain of the amino acid. But the secondary is the, due to the strain on increasing the number of amino acid, it become helical, and helix is due to the hydrogen bonding, and beta pleated structure like the sheet structure, okay, due to the sulfide bonding. Further, when the superposition takes place in the secondary structure, folding takes place, then the globular shape structure is formed, that is known as what? Tertiary structure. And tertiary structure is stabilized by the covalent ionic hydrogen and the disulfide bond. It you have to remember this very important point is here, because some questions arise, multiple choice question, what are the bonds responsible for the tertiary structure, okay. Here covalent ionic hydrogen and disulfide bonds are responsible for the tertiary structure, and further coiling will result the quaternary structure, okay. Now we will come to next, on the basis of hydrolysis product, okay. Simple proteins, only alpha amino acid gives on hydrolysis, such as the albumin. Conjugated protein, which have two part, one is the prosthetic group attached with the protein. For nucleoprotein, nucleic acid is the prosthetic group. Phosphoprotein, phosphoric acid the prosthetic group. Glycoprotein, carbohydrate is the prosthetic group. Metallipoprotein, metal is the prosthetic group. Lipoprotein, lipid is the prosthetic group. This one is the name of proteins, and this one is the name of prosthetic group. If alpha amine amino acid is associated with the non-protein part, then non-protein part is known as prosthetic group, and such proteins are known as conjugated protein. Next one is the derived protein. Partial hydrolysis of the simple or conjugated protein gives the derived proteins. Okay, when we do the partial hydrolysis of the simple or conjugated protein, then we get the derived polypeptides or derived proteins. This is only for the knowledge, not for note, because it is not in your syllabus, but in the competitive examination questions are asked. Now we will classify the enzymes on their basis, proteins on their basis of function. The first one is the structural protein. Fibrous protein, which are found in the muscles, they are the structural protein. Enzymes, which are the biological catalyst, also are the protein. Pepsin, trypsin, these help in the digestion. Hormones, many hormones are the protein. Here is insulin is also, which convert extra glucose into glycogen. Contractile protein, which is found in muscles for the contraction and relaxation, in bicep, tricep muscles. These are the myosin and actin. And antibodies, gamma globulin present in the blood. These are also protein and help in the mental calmness. And blood proteins, that one is the albumin, hemoglobin and fibrinogen. These are the different proteins, are the different function based upon their function. Okay, now I will tell you a little about the hemoglobin. It is a globular protein, and prosthetic group is the heme. It contains iron which carry the oxygen. Okay, and it contains a 574 amino acid unit distributed in the four polypeptide chains, which are associated with the five carbon chain pyrrole ring, you can say. Two chain contains 141 amino acids residues alpha chain, and two chain contains 146 amino acid residue called beta protein. This is about the knowledge for the hemoglobin. Sickle cell anemia is a disease which is genetic disease and caused by the defective hemoglobin, and it is obtained by replacing only one amino acid, okay, glutamic acid, by the valine. If you will learn about the gene codes, there will you see that sickle cell anemia is due to the deformation in which valine inserted at the place of glutamic acid, then the hemoglobin is defective and is loses its oxygen carrying capacity. Okay, once again student, I will tell you about the classification based upon the function. First one is the structure of protein, fibrous protein, which help in the formation of a structure. Body shape we get from the fibrous protein. And enzyme, it is also a protein. All enzymes are protein, and these are biological catalyst in the inside body of any animal, any organism which have metabolic activity. All the metabolic activity is catalyzed by the enzyme. For example, for protein, pepsin and trypsin, these are the enzymes which help in the digestion of protein. Hormones, for example, insulin, as you know that it converts extra glucose in the glycogen, but when its function is not proper, or in old age when insulin secretion become less from the pancreas, or due to tension when it do malfunctions, then diabetes take place. In that condition, secretion of insulin is decreases and conversion of glucose into glycogen also decreases. Okay. Contractile protein, which proteins are help in the contraction and relaxation. It means folding arms and opening arms, which are possible only by the contractile protein. Such proteins are found in muscles, and example is myosin and actin. Antibodies. You know antibodies. What are antibodies? These are the proteins which fight against the germs. Gamma globulin present in blood, mostly it is found in brain. It is a type of antibodies which fight against the germs. Next one is the blood protein. Albumins and hemoglobin and fibrinogen. Albumin and hemoglobins are globular in nature, and fibrinogen is the fibrous in nature. Okay, and their functions are different. and fibrinogen in help in blood clotting. Now see here the hemoglobin. It is a globular protein. As I have told you, it has a prosthetic group. Prosthetic group are the group which are non-protein part attached to the protein. And heme in the hemoglobin help in carrying the oxygen, which contains iron, which is attached with the 4 pyrrole ring in the middle. Okay, it contains 474 amino acids units distributed in the 4 peptide polypeptide chains. 2 chains contain 141 amino acids residues. Each are called alpha chain, and 2 chains contain 146 amino acid residues called beta chains. Okay, one disease is associated with the blood cells in which is known as sickle cell anemia, in which blood cell become like the sickle. You know sickle, what is sickle? It is a special type of instrument which is used in for the harvesting of wheat plant in the villages. When they do farmer do the manual harvesting, they use sickle, and cell becomes sickle cell. And you can see here what is sickle cell. This is the sickle cell. In such condition, oxygen carrying capacity above blood decreases. This is all due to the defective hemoglobin, which is during the formation, or you can say translation of protein from DNA in the cell. When one amino acid is displaced by another, for example glutamic acid is replaced by the valine, then defective hemoglobin is formed, which causes sickle cell anemia, and which a person become unable to carry oxygen in their blood. Therefore they become the patient of respiratory tract. Okay, now when we will discuss about the denaturation of protein, it is also very important topic. 1 marks question asked for this denaturation of protein. As the name suggests, denaturation. What? Denaturation means natural nature of protein change. How it is changed? It is changed by the change in pH, addition of electrolyte, heating, addition of solvent like water, alcohol and acetone. When the process of change is three-dimensional structure of native protein, then it is called denaturation. In such condition, protein does not work like natural protein, but you can't say it is harmful. Curd is also the result of denaturation of protein. And boiled egg is also the result of denaturation, but unboiled egg is more useful than the boiled egg. Anyhow, if we change pH of the solution, adding electrolyte to the protein solution, heating protein solution, or adding the solvent like water, alcohol and acetone, then the three-dimensional structure of the protein is distorted. It means tertiary, secondary and quaternary structure open to the primary structure, and primary structure is useless. This is known as the denaturation of protein. I hope all you understand. Now little about the enzymes. This is also in the surface chemistry. Okay. Enzymes are what? These are the biological catalysts which catalyze the reaction taking place in the लिविंग ऑर्गेनिज्म. ओके, यू नो अबाउट द कैटलिस्ट. व्हाट आर द कैटलिस्ट? कैटलिस्ट आर द ऑर्गेनिक कंपाउंड्स विच इनिशिएट और कंप्लीट द रिएक्शन. इट मीन्स विदाउट द कैटलिस्ट वी कैन नॉट कंप्लीट द रिएक्शन, सम रिएक्शंस. ओके, सिमिलरली इन एंजाइम्स, एंजाइम्स आर हियर ऑल्सो. वट एवर रिएक्शंस टेक्स प्लेस इन आवर बॉडी ड्यूरिंग द मेटाबोलिज्म दैट आर कैटलाइज बाई द एंजाइम्स. ओके, एंड एक्टिविटी ऑफ एंजाइम्स आर इन्हांस्ड बाई द एक्टिविटी ऑफ सर्टेन नॉन प्रोटीनियस कंपोनेंट विच इन्हांस द एक्टिविटी ऑफ एंजाइम्स नोन एज को एंजाइम्स. And these coenzymes are the magnesium ion, magnesium ion, potassium ion, sodium ion, and zinc ion, cobalt ion. These are the coenzymes which activate the activity of enzymes. Some heterocyclic rings, pyrrole, purine, pyridine, sugar residue, phosphoric acid residue. Vitamins are also thiamine, riboflavin also. These are the non-proteinaceous component which enhance the activity of certain enzymes. You know that in the name of carbohydrate, last three word letter was OSE. For example, you say here glucose. Here is the glucose OSE. Okay. Similarly, here is ASE. This denote the name of enzymes. Okay. Means these enzymes act on the same substrate. Root name of the substrate added suffix ASE. Suppose you add here glucase. It means it will catalyze reaction of glucose. Maltase catalyze the reaction of maltase or during the conversion of maltose into glucose. Diastase help in changing the diastase enzyme which help in the disaccharides. Invertase convert sucrose into glucose and fructose. Urease convert urea into ammonia. And these are the name based upon the substrate. Very easy to remember. Now now we'll see here the characteristic feature of enzymes also. Rate of reaction increased by this enzyme if up to the 10 to power 6 to 10 to power 7 times. Specific type of enzyme react with only specific substrate. For example, urease can hydrolyze only urea, not methyl urea, not other. Okay, this show the specific nature. Suppose here is maltase work on the maltose only. Invertase only work on the sucrose. What is this? This is the specific nature of the enzymes. ऑप्टिमम टेम्परेचर इज रिक्वायर्ड फॉर द एक्टिविटी ऑफ एंजाइम, इट मीन्स एट द 20 to 30 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड इट वर्क प्रॉपरली. ओके, पीएच इज मीडियम अबाउट 7 फॉर द पेप्सिन, 1.8 to 2.22 फॉर एंड ट्रिप्सिन, 7.5 to 8.3. दीज आर द पीएच एट विच सम पर्टिकुलर एंजाइम्स वर्क प्रॉपरली, बट अबव एंड बिलो दिस पीएच दे विल नॉट वर्क. कंसंट्रेशन, डायल्यूट सॉल्यूशन इज मोर इफेक्टिव देन द कंसंट्रेटेड सॉल्यूशन. अमाउंट, वेरी वेरी स्मॉल अमाउंट एंजाइम कैन एक्सेलरेट अ रिएक्शन. एंजाइम इनहिबिटर, सम सब्सटेंस विच कैन इनहिबिट द एंजाइम एक्शन विद हेल्प ऑफ सच कंपाउंड, सम रिएक्शन कैन बी कंट्रोल्ड. ओके, नाउ वी विल सी द मैकेनिज्म. ओके, व्हाट इज मैकेनिज्म ऑफ द एंजाइम एक्शन? एंजाइम रिएक्ट विद द पर्टिकुलर सबस्ट्रेट एंड देन फॉर्म द एंजाइम सबस्ट्रेट, दैट इज द प्रोडक्ट, देन गिव द प्रोडक्ट एंड एंजाइम एक्टिवेटेड कॉम्प्लेक्स. स्टूडेंट, इट इज वेरी सिमिलर टू द ओपनिंग ऑफ लॉक. अ पर्टिकुलर की वर्क इन द पर्टिकुलर लॉक. वेन वी यूज पर्टिकुलर की इन पर्टिकुलर लॉक, देन इट कंबाइंड फॉर सम टाइम एंड फॉर्म द एंजाइम सबस्ट्रेट कॉम्प्लेक्स, एंड वेन लॉक इज ओपन इट फॉर्म द प्रोडक्ट एंड की इज ऑल्सो सेपरेटेड लाइक द एंजाइम. Now we'll see the application of enzyme. As you know, it is also used for the treatment of some diseases. Okay, first you think one congenital disease. What is congenital disease? Which is the those diseases which are from the birth, which are the genetical diseases? Phenylketonuria, which is caused by the phenylalanine hydroxylase, which can cured by the diet of low phenylalanine content. Okay, similarly streptokinase is used for the blood clotting to prevent the heart disease. Okay, these are the treatment used for the diseases. In industry, tanning of the leather, fermentation process for preparation of the alcohol. Okay, nucleic acid we will see in the next about the nucleic acid. Once again I will tell you about the characteristic of enzymes. Enzymes are the biological catalyst which catalyze the biological activities, biological reaction inside the body, and it accelerate the rate of reaction up to 6 to 10 to power 7 times. And enzymes are the specific nature, means specific type of enzymes work on the specific type of substrate. For example, urease work on the urea, not on the methyl urea. Maltose work on the maltose. Okay, and similarly the lactase work on the lactose in sugar, which is the milk sugar. And for the proper work of enzyme, there is optimum temperature. Below or above that temperature, enzyme do not work. That is the 20 to 30 degree centigrade. pH of the medium is also important. For example, 7, about the it is 7, below or above, some enzymes do not work, but some enzymes work on the particular one. For example, by the pepsin 1.8 to 2.2, trypsin from 7.5 to 8.3, they work properly. Concentration is also important factor. Enzyme work in the dilute solution very well, and the amount of enzyme, very little amount of enzyme used to accelerate the reaction. And some inhibitors are used for the controlling the reaction which is accelerated by the enzymes. And student, enzyme work like the lock and key, when suppose key is the enzyme, lock is the substrate, you have to open this. When you insert the key, after rotating the key, enzyme substrate substrate complex is formed, which on opening give the open key lock, which is product, and key as such. Similarly, under all the in the all reaction, enzymes remain safe. And application of enzyme, I have told you, treatment of diseases, and in industry it is used in the tanning of leather, fermentation means preparation of alcohol, acetic acid. Okay, student. Now, in the next video, we will discuss about the nucleic acid importance, preparation, structures. Okay. Now, I will close. You learn properly. Okay. Thank you.